For years and years and years, I was a huge advocate of Screencast-O-Matic. I used it for everything, and I thought the functionality of it was tremendous. I still think there's some winning features to it, but I've been using Loom a lot more lately. I'm going to tell you why in this video. Before we get started, make sure you guys like and subscribe. And don't forget, there is a podcast, Startup U Podcast, you can check out as well. Here on this channel, we talk about tools, tips, and marketing strategies all to grow or start your business. Something that I really like about this is if you're doing things as a business owner, like you're reviewing assets for clients, right? Or there's some kind of, like you have a remote team and so you're trying to give instruction or guidance, this is going to be a great tool for you. And it's going to supersede, I think, some of the limitations that some of the other tools like Screencast-O-Matic provide. But you'll see here, this is, if you just go to loom.com, this is the browser version. There is a extension you can add here. And I actually really recommend it. I'm using the Chrome extension here. Basically, I would just click, I'm not going to do it because I'll lose the video, but it pops up and it gives you some brief examples of things that you can do. So it's, if you want to include your pretty face down here, you can do that. And that's interesting because sometimes with some of these other screencast recording type tools, you don't have that. So that's a cool feature. I have mine turned off at the moment, but you could have your face there. So like right now we could be jiving on that and you're watching the screen doing what it's doing, right? So really cool feature there. If not, you can just do a little image of yourself and all well and good. I have found at times I have to move it around because it does get in the way. Like if I'm talking about something in this bottom left corner, it's like, oh, got to move my face, you know? So maybe that's not as ideal, but by and large, I think it's totally fine. So you'll see here, here's your library of things that you've created. So you'll see we do a lot of reviews for clients and stuff like that. Now, a big winning feature that this tool has that other tools don't have, and I'm going to see if this one is one that has it. This was a review that I did for someone. You can actually leave comments. So this one doesn't have any specifically, but as the person is reviewing your review for them, she can comment back and forth with me and it'll actually show a timestamp. So it's like if at minute two, I said something as far as giving her advice out of a 21-minute video, I don't have to figure out what she's talking about because it's going to show me exactly timestamp when she dropped that comment so I can go back and listen to it if I forgot. We do a lot of these. We're reviewing things for students and we're creating stuff for employees and stuff like that. And so it's great to have the ability to go access these things and archive and look at the archives of different things that you've done here. So that is a super, super huge winning feature. The other thing is this, and for a while, Screencast-O-Matic was great because you could actually bookmark it down here. It's not really, is that what it's called? Pinned to your bookmark? Anyway, you know what I'm talking about. Pin to start, pin to bookmark, something like that. But then it kind of just stopped working, right? And so that's not great. Now, something that is really cool about something like Screencast-O-Matic that I haven't figured out how to use with this tool, and I'm not sure if you can, I think you can. I think you'd have to go to the desktop version, not the browser version. The browser version is going to allow you to review things on the internet. So like, let's say we're reviewing this video, right? Then I could provide commentary on this video and critiques to the editor, right? But let's say I want to review something on like an image that I pull up just on my desktop, right? It's not a I'm pretty confident that you could just use the browser version because it's going to view your whole screen, not just that tab. Right. So it still would allow you to accomplish that. You just have to go to a browser and then pull something off of your screen on your desktop to show it. So that's maybe a little bit different than something like Screencast-O-Matic, where you have that bookmark right here at the bottom where you just go boom and it just does anything regardless of what's on your screen. So that might confuse people as it kind of, I just had to think myself through, like, I've done that before. How did I do that? But yeah, so you can see here, this is great because you can access all of these videos. That's not dissimilar to a large degree. But again, the commenting aspect of things, I think, is huge. The ability to quickly share a link, I think, is really cool. There's some pretty cool customization type things you can do here. So you can change the video player. I like when I share this with somebody, when I share the link, it kind of shows like a GIF version of the video. I think that's really interesting. It's really engaging. But this is pretty cool, too. So you can add your own logo. So like if you're doing stuff for client work, like I mentioned before, how legit do you look if, like, bam, right there on the corner of the screen, you've got your logo? That's pretty slick. And then remove the made with Loom button. Okay, yeah. So if you want to like make it look like it's yours, your fancy tool, whatever, not have their label, you can do that as well. It looks like those are all potentially for the free option. I'm in a paid option, so I don't know, but that's something to look into if you have that for a paid option, which leads me to my next thing I was going to talk about. So $8 a month per seat, right? So depending on how many people are on your team, that could get a little bit, expensive, right? So you have to consider that. But there is a free version, and I found it to be pretty beneficial. As you can see here, you can kind of compare, you know, the differences. The biggest thing was this, the limitation on the amount of videos you can do, right? Whereas you can do unlimited here. This is why I had to upgrade. And then this can be a challenge, albeit it can also be beneficial. So if you're doing client work, and let's say you just archive the old ones so you can do more than 25, right? That shouldn't be an issue. Having that five minute limit, it kind of keeps you accountable. So you're not dropping like 30 minute reviews like we do asset reviews for students and clients. It kind of keeps you accountable to like being concise, which I'm not doing right now. But yeah, so, but either way, $8 a month, I think is great. If you're doing like one-on-one client work and it's not going to be a team of 20 people, I think $8 is more than justifiable, right? So pretty, pretty solid options there. Now, something else that I like here too, and I didn't show this before when it comes to analyzing what's happening. So you can actually see, and this is interesting because this is something you can't do. So let's say you are working with clients, students, et cetera, it'll show you if someone's watching something, if they have, see, like I can see people's names, the people that watch the video. So I know if I sent something to somebody, if they viewed it or not. So my response to them as a follow-up is going to be totally different than if they have, I know they haven't seen it. And that's really, I use Streak and I use BombBomb, and those are things that really benefit me specifically with like outreach type things, right? For like pitching people and stuff like that. So that may be something that comes into play for you, where it's like you want to know if they viewed it so you know how to respond appropriately. So really, really cool stuff here. Like you can see someone left a thumbs up at 4 minutes. So I can go see what they're thumbing up. Otherwise, I would just be like, are you thumbing up the whole video or are you thumbing? Right. So this is cool because it kind of gives you notifications about all of your activity and on which video. So that's really awesome. And you can actually allow it to notify you. Like if somebody does something, like it, let's say it's a, you need a prompt response, boom, you're right there. You're ready to rock and roll. Now, let me share this because all the other things I love, I think this is a very versatile tool. I think it's tremendous. I think it's an awesome way for business owners to communicate the things they want and to share information, guidance, resources, et cetera, and not have to repeat themselves 100 million times. And I think that's obviously always a benefit. Here's what I don't like. The big drawback of this tool that they have got to fix like tomorrow, literally, when you're recording a video, and I'm assuming that you can see this down here. I'm not sure if it actually populates as I'm recording, but basically if it's not, you'll see I have a stop button, a pause, and a delete, like a trash button, right? Where I can get rid of things. Now, here's the deal. With something like Streamcast-O-Matic, if I pause this recording because I said something that I'm like, I don't like that. And if I'm doing a 30-minute video, the likelihood of that happening is pretty high. It's kind of like a typewriter. Like you couldn't go back and just hit the backspace button. That's the equivalence of this. There is no backspace. Whereas you can go back and truncate videos and re-record, but not lose your whole video with something like Streamcast-O-Matic. Why this tool doesn't have that ability, that functionality, when it has all these other bells and whistles included, is beyond me. I genuinely do not know why that's not a feature. In fact, I think they're grossly missing the ball here. But if I was the type of person like just getting used to doing that and I'm worried about making mistakes, now I'm in my head and I know I can't go back and re-record what I said. I got to start the whole thing over again. And there have been times when I've created 20-minute videos where I screwed up at the end and I'm like, that's not what I wanted to say. Got to go back and restart the whole thing. That has got to change. So that is my biggest drawback. If nothing else, I think this tool is going to be great. As you can see, so much functionality here. If there's some you want to star and like save for later, you can start in that category. You can archive them. There's just so much that you can do and so much that I feel like is going to benefit you with this specific tool. Again, if you're a business owner looking to provide reviews for people or clients, customers, students, et cetera, I think you're going to be in great, great shape. And I love the browser extension. I can just record things like that. It's amazing. I get things done so fast. And I use it almost every single day. So wanted to share that resource with you because I think it's a great, has an awesome free level, but also super low price point for a basic level that's going to get you pretty much everything that you need. All right, hope you like this video. There are three ways you can work with me beyond this if you so choose to do so. The first is my Ultimate Startup Checklist. All these are 100% free to get started. So Ultimate Startup Checklist is my womb to tomb guide, my playbook of everything you should be doing to start your business the right way. If you're also starting your business and you're like, I don't know what kind of business, I know what kind of the business industry that I want to be in, but I don't necessarily know the model is best for me. It's It's going to be what type of business should you start? I'll tell you kind of examples of other people and what they've done and how they did it. So you build a business around your life, not a life around your business. Don't create an unnecessary prison for yourself. I've done it. It's not fun. And then lastly is our free class. It's 35 minutes long, almost 40 minutes long. And what it's going to give you is how to market and sell yourself, whether you have an online business or an offline business, without sounding hokey, gimmicky, salesy, sounding organic, sounding authentic, sounding like yourself, and getting higher conversions, making more sales. All those links are included in the description. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe for more, hit the bell for notifications, comment below, and I'll see you in the next one.